Over the centuries, humans have faced countless problems. There have been deadly diseases, long periods of droughts, and natural disasters. Yet humanity has always survived and persisted on. But is it really only to become the cause of our climate going completely haywire? Arctic ice melting, deserts expanding, oceans rising centimeter by centimeter. Climate change is caused by many industries and takes a toll on many industries, including agriculture. Recently, a specific red seaweed has been proven to have the ability to immensely reduce the methane produced by cows and sheep, who are large contributors to agricultural greenhouse gas emissions. This is an opportunity for both agriculture and aquaculture to battle the headaches of climate change through healthy food choices for us and the food we eat. Climate change will have varying effects depending on the location in the globe. For Canada specifically, Canada Atlas says agricultural regions will likely see drier summers from coast to coast and increased winter and spring precipitation. With these facts, Canadian farmers will be forced to deal with excessive water during seeding and fresh sprouting season and insufficient water during growing season. Robin Tunnicliffe has been a Canadian farmer for over 20 years. She remembers how her mentor had given her a list of days crucial to farmers. She remembered thinking, good, now I know what I'm doing. But as the years went by, she realized these dates were nothing but expired knowledge. Crops aren't the only thing getting affected. Practically a third of all crops are used to feed livestock. And since crops are decreasing due to weather, diseases, and increasing natural disasters, there will be less to feed livestock, which means less to feed people. Climate change has many nasty effects and causes a massive amount of disturbance to humans and nature. And although many of the world's issues is caused by climate change, this is still an opportunity for both agriculture and aquaculture to battle climate change. An opportunity for agriculture to reduce methane in the industry. An opportunity for agriculture to help reduce methane in agriculture. All with the feathery red seaweed. Commonly known as the red sea plume, scientifically known as Asparagopsis taxiformis. According to Verge Science, livestock is responsible for approximately 8 to 10% of all agricultural greenhouse gas emissions. To solve a problem, we have to get to the root of the problem. Cows and sheep have four stomachs, which makes their digestive system quite unique. They have the ability to turn the useless parts of their food into edible nutrients. However, this process of fermenting their food creates methane, which is then released into the atmosphere by not commonly known as farting, but rather burping. Knowing this, the issue is not the cow itself, but the methanogenic microbes that react inside the digestive system. Scientists thought, what if something in their food could make these microbes just, not react? This is where the feathery red seaweed comes in. It did exactly that. There was a trial done at UC Davis where they found adding 1% of the red sea plume into the food of cows and sheep reduces methane production by 60%, while 2% eradicates almost all of it. What if we solve this agricultural problem through aquaculture in a safe, sustainable, and eco-friendly way, using our oceans to save our planet? Greener Grazing is a project focusing on producing the red sea plume with safe, sustainable methods. They believe sea-based farming is the best way to produce. Greener Grazing is planning to mass cultivate and produce the red sea plume by having ropes hanging in the ocean with red sea plume growing on the ropes. Now, even with the red sea plume, livestock will still cause an amount of methane. Because of science, we now have the choice to eat the average burger or the impossible burger. Some of you may have seen the A&W ad advertising the Beyond Meat Nuggets. It is said in these ads that these nuggets are 100% plant-based. And now the question arises, how can meat not be meat? Well, currently there are two ways. One, cell-based meat. Two, plant-based meat. Both of them having the ability to reduce methane production by reducing the amount of meat we consume. One. Cell-based meat is where the stem cells of an animal are extracted and grown in petri dishes with amino acids. Cell-based meat is still meat, but it is grown instead of animals being raised. Now, plant-based meat, on the other hand, does not contain the slightest bit of actual meat. Sensory scientists sit around in a lab sniffing meat, writing down what it smells like, and finding the perfect non-meat equivalent. The key to actual meat is something called heme. Heme is what makes meat taste, smell, look like meat. It was soon found that heme can be found in soy plants. Scientists have been exploring plant options that recreate the senses that make meat, meat. Picture this. We're in the future, and planet Earth is now recovering. Our once sick planet is now healthy, and we've restored some of its natural beauty. I'll see you when we meet on the healthier, brighter side of Earth. Because an environmentally friendly ninja leaves no footprint. And in our case, this environmentally friendly ninja is the feathery red seaweed and three choices of meat.